Good evening, good evening. Let's get started. Hit the all-time record this morning for cold, 25 degrees here for this date. Yeah, so we're outside here in the evening time, but we're keeping our good habits going, all right, which is what I've said. Keep your good habits going. Continue to diet. Continue to jog. Continue to tape. Continue to do everything the right way and staying in sync here. Now, let's talk about the four pillars of this teaching. Four pillars of this teaching, and then there's a fifth to top it off. The fifth is a roof. We have four pillars and then a roof of this teaching. So I'm going to talk about these four pillars. The first one is there's only one problem, and you know what that is. It's the continuity problem. That is maybe the most important pillar because it centers you. It centers you and empowers you. Okay, only one problem. The continuity problem. Not millions of problems, not hundreds, not even four or five, whatever. One problem, because if we solve the continuity problem, all our problems will vanish for us, because we will no longer be deluded. We will no longer try to change what is. The second pillar is existence is a whim. Okay, what gave rise to all of this nonsense, this impermanence, this dance of impermanence like clouds? What gave rise to it was a whim. Very important. Not insanity. Spirit is not insane. The Son of God is not insane. God is like the super matrix. God the Father is like the super matrix. Super smooth, pure spaciousness, pure absence, super matrix within which everything arises. God the Son is the arising within that super matrix. God the Holy Spirit is the pragmatic action, pragmatism to solve the continuity problem that we have. So it was Spirit that had a whim of being greater than reality. Spirit said, you know what, reality's great, but I can do better. You know, this creation of God's great, but I can do better. That's a whim. Whim gave rise to this dance of impermanence, okay? Gave rise to existence. Only whim. It's just a whim. Just a whim. The third pillar is, there's only one answer to this, to solve the continuity problem. Only one answer, and that is to see a blessed world, to see a blessed universe. That's the only answer, meaning everything that you perceive or experience or sense, everything is in association with eternal life, which is pure spaciousness, God. You see everything in association with eternal life, okay? That is the way to resolve the continuity problem. There's only one way to resolve it. You can use different verbiage and stuff, but it's still, just like you can point different ways to the sun. You can point with one finger, two fingers, this like this, palm, two palms, both hands, you know, straight hand, whatever. Different ways of pointing to the sun, different verbiage, but it's still only one way to do it, and that is to see a blessed world, to see everything without exception in having an association with eternal life. Okay. And the fourth pillar is to realize that whim will say it has a better answer than the Holy Spirit's answer, which is this blessed world. Whim will say, oh yeah, that's great, but I've got something better. Now trace that back. Remember that existence self-sprung into spaciousness because Spirit had this whim, like, I want to be prime creator. And he said, you know what, God, this is wonderful, but I can do better. Okay, so when we say, hey, we have this perfect one answer to the continuity problem that we have, whim will say, oh yeah, that's great, but I can do better. So why waste time on something like this when we can spend our time in getting something better? So whim will string you along like that. So this is the pillar of defensiveness, saying, yeah, I can do better than that, actually. I can do better than that. Not in verbiage, not in how you phrase it, but fundamentally, whim says, fundamentally, it can do better fundamentally. So the differences between different teachers, etc., those are superficial cultural differences, verbiage, phrasing, emphasis, all this stuff. They're still pointing to the same one solution, which is to see a blessed world. They're all pointing there. But WHIM says fundamentally it can do better. Fundamentally, it says no, you don't need to see a blessed world. There's something better. WHIM will always say there's something better. There's always something better. It always, and then that catches your ear and you say, oh wow, I don't want to settle for second best or something. Now, the fifth pillar is pragmatism, which is your needs in the world, the support of the other four pillars, the roof over your head, as it were. So the pragmatic, practical stuff is food, shelter, you know, and transportation, and being able to pay fees and pay your bills, etc. That's something that also, that's a pragmatic, has to be dealt with. So the support for your path is very important. That's the fifth pillar. Now, the Holy Spirit might be likened to a gardener, okay? And it's got all these vegetables and plants growing that bear fruit and vegetables. And it's like a really good gardener. It tends to the plants, it prunes them, it weeds them, it waters them, it fertilizes them, it protects them, etc. Now, like for instance, I have a vegetable garden, and the meteorologist said the Arctic jet stream's coming down, there's an Arctic air is coming in, and it's going to be really, really cold. And everybody was saying that. So I said, you know what? Maybe they're right this time. I'm not going to risk it. Maybe they're wrong, but maybe they're right. And so what I did was I covered the vegetable garden. I put freeze cloth on stuff and, you know, put a big effort into protecting all the vegetables. And so far, I believe they've all survived, okay? If I hadn't have done that, they're dead. So I'm a good gardener. I protect my valuable produce from a hard freeze. Okay, now we have been told and tipped off quite a bit by those in the know that in the world there's going to be a time of great belligerence towards truth. Okay, great belligerence on this part of the ego, very severe. If you liken it to weather, you might say an Arctic blast is coming down from the north, and the jet stream is going to just hit us so hard and put us into a deep, hard freeze. Sociologically, ideologically, politically, economically, there's a very severe mindset at play in the world. Very, very severe. And I've gone over that in hundreds of videos. So, if you're a good gardener, what are you going to do? If those in this world are your plants, like I'm like a plant growing, tomato plant giving off tomato, blossoming, giving off tomatoes or whatever, and you realize there's this hard freeze coming, what are you going to do? You're going to protect the plants. You're going to protect. So the Holy Spirit should protect its garden. Its garden consists of a spiritual aspirants. That's the Holy Spirit's garden. That's what it does. It protects the spiritual aspirants and nurtures them as they grow in clarity to the four pillars. Okay, the four pillars are not easy to get those four pillars. Lifetime of work, really, to be able to condense everything down and just see very clearly what the essence of it is. So the Holy Spirit nurtures spiritual aspiration, and when things get really, really cold, and you can tell there's a severe cold spell coming, a sociological cold spell, the Holy Spirit's got to cover and protect the crop that it's going, protect the spiritual aspirants of the world. It's a no-brainer. I mean, it's obvious. If I can protect my, you know, my garden, the Holy Spirit's got to protect this garden. That's how I see it, very strongly. And so, if not, the crop is going to die, for sure. I mean, the harshness is coming. It is putting so much pressure on us. It's just an insane amount of pressure. You can feel it and say, oh my gosh, you can feel this change. When this Arctic jet stream started coming down into California, you just said, uh-oh, you know, what's going on here? The thing that feels like, it was like 75 degrees, about a week ago. Beautiful, wow, shorts and t-shirts, just wonderful. And then suddenly, boom, here it comes. In a day, it had flipped. In 2 days, it was bad. In 3 days, it was 26 degrees. So it can happen very fast. And it's super important to protect the crops ahead of time, which I did. I got the very last day, I got it protected just in time for the hard frost. So I expect the Holy Spirit to do exactly the same thing as protect the spiritual aspirants of the world, those who are really after it. I mean, really putting the work in. And to get those four pillars, that's an example of really putting the work in, being able to condense it all down to its total roots, basic structure. Okay, that is very difficult to do. So protection, that's the fifth pillar, is protection. Protect the spiritual aspirants. And that's something that's out of our hands. We're told if we do our part, Holy Spirit does its part, pragmatically. They're just pragmatic steps to protect spiritual aspirants is super important. So, how close are we? Well, very close, I would say. December 20th, I would say, is sort of a cutoff date. And I'm definitely feeling that come January, there's going to be a new harsh climate in the world in relation to things can change so fast in this world. There are various legal decisions can happen. There are so many activists in the world who are targeting people of spiritual aspiration right now, and it's things can go south in a hurry. Okay, they really can. I've seen like a severe storm coming upon the world, probably not just from rain, but actually a rain of heavy-handed rain toward those who are not towing the line. They have, with all this data they've collected, you know, they know who everybody is, what their ideologies are, and so just like Google, for instance, suddenly shut off comments, you know, on these videos, which I feel is an extraordinarily heavy-handed move, actually without any warning or any public forum or input from anybody that I was aware of. They just unilaterally decided to shut all commenting down from any, in order to comment, you have to sign up for Google Plus. That is really, in my opinion, a severe blow to free speech. Okay, the internet's supposed to foster free speech. How free is it if you have to sign up for Google Plus and have all your data mined from that? That's not free speech. And so it was unilaterally done without any warning, and it's really changed the whole nature of what I do and the whole feel of it all to a detriment. So I really had to disable comments because really many people refuse to sign up for Google Plus. Most people refuse to sign up for it, so they're shut out. They're shut out of commenting. That's not fair. That's not right. It's not right at all. So I'm not getting balanced feedback. I'm not getting balanced feedback from the world because of that move. So that's just one little example. Unilateral decisions can be made all over the place now. There's a climate of just, you know, we're going to do what we want to do in the world. So I expect the Holy Spirit has got to be the fifth pillar and put a roof over our heads right now. Some sort of sanctuary, some sort of refuge. I've been talking about that for years, and it just simply has to do it, because I don't have any answer for the fifth pillar. I've done my work, the four pillars, clarified everything, and I'm very clear about it all. And so the fifth pillar is up to the Holy Spirit. You know, that's its ultimate job, is to do that. And so I'm just praying that takes place for all spiritual aspirants. All spiritual aspirants should be protected at this time, all of them. Those who have gone beyond just mere intellectual, getting it intellectually, you know, anyone can get it intellectually. The real work is to internalize it, so you are just an extemporaneous, like a musician. Let's take like a studio musician, okay? You can give them just a little riff or a little jingle or something, and then they can spin out a whole song, you know, just they just nail it. They can just extemporaneously, spontaneously, they can just figure out some beautiful melody and the whole thing. That's a studio musician. That's a real musician. That's somebody who's got the theory down totally. All right, and they just know the whole thing. It's fabulous. Same thing on the spiritual path. You have to internalize it. You have to have it down completely, and there's no resistance, and you're able just to, you know, whatever is said, you're able to spin it in the right direction. Okay, like a super studio musician. That's what we have to get to. And so there's a huge difference between getting it intellectually and being a real studio musician with it. Huge difference. That's what takes all the work. They're really, I mean, anybody can hit an E chord on electric guitar and say, wow, listen to that. And a studio musician can take a couple of notes you throw at them and spin out just a, you know, gorgeous, gorgeous composition from it. And then the next one do it completely different, the next one completely different. I mean, see, it's really different, very different. So hard work, discipline of continuing to condense it down to the four pillars, seeing how they all go together. Existence is just a whim. Whim gives rise to a continuity problem, okay? We only have one problem, it's the continuity problem. Continuity problem is solved by seeing a blessed world / universe, okay, which is all things in association with eternal life. Seeing that, or pure spaciousness, the ground being God. Seeing everything in association with that. That solves the continuity problem. The ego, whim, ego is just a voice of whim, actually. Whim will say, hey, that's great, but I got something better for you. And then you have to be able to resist that pressure, that guilt pressure that whim puts on you. Very, very severe marketing tactics that whim use. All of that has to be settled within you. Ultimately, you have to keep the ball rolling in that direction. Now, the harshness that is to come in this world, the very harsh deep freeze designed to kill the vegetables and fruits and vegetables. It's designed to kill the fruits and vegetables, okay? To cause them to wither. What does that cause? Your resolve to wither, okay? The beat down is coming. And it'll attempt to try to collapse your will to keep on this path. It's coming. It's already been moving in big time. And once a front and system moves in and settles over you, then that's when the hard freeze happens. You know, first night gets dropped, temperature drops down. Second night gets close to freezing. Third night suddenly it plummets. You know, fourth night, fifth night. Last night was just in 25, just crushing cold. Is amazing. That's how it works. That's how it works. So it's designed to just get you to give up. Just give up. Give it up. You know, it's too much. I just can't do it. I can't do it. It's too much for me. That's what is going to come in this world. Jesus pointed it out in the Bible, saying the end of the cycle, end of this age, the pressure will be so severe on this planet that even the elect of God, meaning those who have chosen the path to solve the continuity problem, to accept the solution of the continuity problem, even they will be in danger of giving up, collapsing into giving up. So, yeah, I'm just waiting for the fifth pillar, the roof. And yeah, if it doesn't come for me, I can't guarantee I won't collapse. No, nobody can. I mean, the pressure's already insane. It's just insane here. The stigma. You know, the stigma attached to speaking truth now is just incredible. There's so many, many, many angles that the pressure is coming from, that it's just like, you know, Gulliver's Travel. You tie all these Lilliputians that tie down Gulliver, and can't move. Tied in so many different ways, right? Tied up in so many different ways. So it's just getting brutal, just brutal. So we're calling upon the Holy Spirit intensely to supply the fifth pillar, all right? The fifth pillar is absolutely essential. And maybe that's the fifth dimension, okay? It's possible. That's very possible, the fifth pillar being the fifth dimension. Is a refuge, a sanctuary for us. Because we still have to keep working on this whole tricky dynamic. It's a chess game. It's a chess game with whim. Whim is completely mad, you know, it's completely whimsical, and yet it pretends it's not, and so it keeps suckering you into it, and then suddenly it'll do something, and you say, wow, wait, I'm lost, what happened, it whim pretends to not be whim, but it is whim, the whim of believing that what is not, that's whim, to believe that reality isn't reality, or that to believe that there's something better, or something greater than reality, that's whim. And that is what we are, engages with us, as the ego engages with us, and we have immense trouble with it, just terrible, because it's just so fluid and pretending that it's something other than what it is, and it disguises itself and hides it, and just it's brutally difficult. Gradually, you know, edge away from whim, edge away from whim towards seeing a blessed world, seeing everything in association with eternal life, which solves the continuity problem, and that's all we need. That's all we need. Okay, so was it December 9th? For me, I got 11 more days to keep the habits very strong, very positive, and then I expect the fifth pillar to come into play. It needs to come into the picture right now. There's no question about it. That is fundamental role of the Holy Spirit, besides providing the vision of the blessed world and orchestrating our path and have this tending the garden, covering the garden with like frost cloth. That's super important. Super important. You cannot just allow those who are on the spiritual path, who are, you know, to just be frozen by the harshness of what's coming, the ideological harshness. You can't just allow that, because then you're just throwing away all your hard work. Maybe there's a lemon tree that is loaded with lemon, beautiful lemons, you know, just gorgeous yellow lemons, which is so useful. And you say, wow, I'm going to be able to use those lemons for lemonade and for salad dressing and for seasoning and everything. Just wonderful. This lemon tree, and here comes this hard frost, and it's, you know, it's going to kill the ruin the lemons, kill the tree. You can't just allow that to happen, because that undermines, you know, everybody else's aspiration. You've got to protect spiritual assets. Have to be protected. They have to be protected for the good of everybody else, because that lemon tree may feed a lot of people really nice lemonade. You see? Okay, so you know. Right at this point, I don't have any clue exactly of what's going to happen going into this, you know, latter third of this December into January. So stay tuned and we'll find out. Okay, stay centered. Remember the four pillars. Number one, the continuity problem is the only problem I have. It's a huge problem, but it's the only problem that I have. Just say that. It immediately centers you and gives you, it's kryptonite, it's the Achilles heel to the ego, okay, to whim. It's the Achilles heel. It's the Achilles heel. Say, I've got one problem and it's the continuity problem. That is something that whim greatly troubles women. And whim says, you know, can't deal with that. Cannot deal with that. So just keep on that. The first pillar, I have one problem, it's the continuity problem. Then the other pillars will start coming into place. All right, very great.